cause I'm on fire. I can't give a fuck about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Never play by the rules, that's what I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude, poison the multitude. They be quick to accuse, when you got different views. Just know you gon' pay the price, best up an item you choose.
Many ties in the culture, hit you with MK Ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't trust you, shock you, deny you, fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered, doing this so subtle. Fumbling out through the rubble, remember this in jungle. The top, I was gonna get something, the middle, gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing, why the rush up for nothing. Why the rush up for nothing, why the rush up for nothing. Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. The institution, modern day execution. Think I knew the solution. Maybe not should I do it. Just put it in the music. Just put it in the music.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give a fuck about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave. You'll burn out if you jump into the fire. Can you feel it rushing?
Looks like it's going to be a pretty soggy night here at TIAA Bank Field. Rain showers, maybe an occasional clap of thunder supposed to continue throughout here in Jacksonville. This crowd excited to see their Jaguars as both teams emerge from their tunnels a moment ago. We are just about ready for football as the Jags get set to match up with the Miami Dolphins. The final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are as we are off and running on EA Sports. And he won't quite make it to the 25.
Grant on the return. The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver, but he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front, so if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him, picks up three on that carry.
And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. It'll go as a gain of seven on the play, and it sets up a third and inches situation.
Brings up third and inches.
They'll try to pick this up on the ground with Breida, and he is going to have the Dolphins first down, maybe by about a yard as they find a way to convert on third and inches. Just a gain of a couple, but good enough to keep the drive rolling. Now they'll throw with Tagovailoa. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Cox. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. Charles, Thursday night game, what do you think? A lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So as you said, you shrink the playbook, pick out the plays that work best for you. And you know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off of the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
Tua gets this one into the hands of Williams. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 7 yards there and a first down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Ready.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Tua going to hand this one to Breida. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Completes it to the tight end, Smythe. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. It's a gain. Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, stepping back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow.
Oh, it was hit at the line of scrimmage and intercepted. Picked off at the 46. Past the 20. And he will take this one home. That's a touchdown. And the defense could not have written a much better script than that first drive, pick six.
The offense never got a chance to really get oiled up there, did they? But the defense, they certainly got in gear. What a big-time play and a great way for them to start.
And now the offense, they've got to turn things around and figure this out because your backs are on the ground real quickly.
Yeah, usually when you're starting the game getting the ball, 0-0 is the only score you're worried about. Now the second time you get it, you're already down a touchdown.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give them 14 on that one and a first down.
14. First down, Dolphins.
Here's Tua. He's airing it out for Williams. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Now it's Breida. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going, and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Give the sack to Aaron Lynch, the former USF Bull.
I spent a lot of extra time preparing for this game, watching this offensive line, because they gave up 5 sacks last week in their loss. They just gave up another one now. They don't seem to be working together as a cohesive unit, right? 4 guys might have it right, but the 5th guy is giving something up. They've got to find a way to all get on the same page.
That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down.
5 yards.
When I see Mike Gesicki make a catch, I'm reminded of his athletic ability. And go back to the time we were leading up to the draft and showing his career highlights, including high school volleyball, where he appeared he was almost jumping over the net. I expect him to continue to grow in 2020, start to make progress in 2019. 5 touchdown catches and 570 total yards.
Oh, he's going up top for Wilson. That's going to be caught. And he just falls short down at the 1-yard line. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. Tua gonna run the sneak, and they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mucked that down for a win in the defense's column.
And they'll let the fullback try and take him home. And the avenue collapsed for him as he's going to be held up short of the goal line. They're held again, and do we have a goal line stand brewing? It's third and goal. Right now, no questioning the toughness of this Jaguar defense. This is third and goal. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Patrick Laird, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
Well, they decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times, that's a passing play.
The kicker, this has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although, I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
A first carry now for Thompson. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Second and nine at the 26 yard line.
Shotgun snap now for Kaepernick. Escaping the pressure right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
It's now third down and 9 yards to go.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Now a play fake, Kaepernick. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And that's caught inside the 30. And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. These two teams all tied after one.
7-7.
So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Working from the gun, it's Kaepernick. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. Another first down as he went right back to the same well, this time for 17 yards.
Jaguars, first down. First and goal at the 6 yard line.
And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8 yard line. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. Again, they'll throw with Kaepernick. Got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. DJ Chark, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Jaguars have taken the lead.
They went five wide in that offensive set, and racing, going three wide is a big deal. To go five, how about the way that they finish things off?
Did you just fit a race car reference into the game?
Zoom, zoom. How about the way that you play? When you go five wide, that means you're going fast now.
Zoom, zoom indeed.
14.
A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good, and that makes the score 14-7. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away.
Taken about 7 yards deep. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it.
At their own 25-yard line.
Number
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10.
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Josh Jones.
What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
They'll run on first down. Thompson, and this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
Running out of the wild.
Both of these two teams, the Jets and Dolphins, looking to improve their rushing attack in 2020. Last year, they were the bottom two teams in the league in terms of rushing yards. The Jets at 31, and the Dolphins dead last at number 32.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. From the gun, it's Kaepernick. There goes a deep ball, end zone. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down. So instead of fourth down, first down.
Well, so much for winning the down you put a lot of emphasis on, because third down is key for offense and defense. Instead, you're going to stay on the field and start a new set of downs.
After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal. To throw, it's Kaepernick. Dancing to his left. And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. LaVisca Chenault with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Jaguars add 6 to their lead.
Josh Lambeau lining up for the point after.
It took them an extra look, but they found out it is a touchdown indeed. The official says this one counts. Extra point tacked on by Lambeau, and it's now 21-7.
Josh Lambeau to kick off for Jacksonville.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And this not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness. Maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
Complete to Preston Williams. A 7.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3.
49-yard line.
They go counter with Breida. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And finally down at the 36-yard line. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. On play action, here's Tua. Got an open man, it's Washington. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
14. First down, Dolphins.
Here's Tagovailoa on first and 10. Steps away to his left. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. They were trying to get it to DeAndre Washington. And it's second down.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield, because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
Tua with a throw complete to Parker. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4.
Complete to Devontae.
18 yards on his first catch of the game. It's a first down.
At the 4-yard line.
first and goal, Washington. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
This defense is really fooling around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
2 wants to throw it on second down toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Parker, the intended target, but now it's third and goal.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
About a half yard from the end zone, third and goal. And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. This defense bending but not breaking. It's a gain of 3. It's now fourth and goal.
It's fourth and goal at the 2-yard line.
Can this defense hold him out? Here we go now. Fourth and goal from the 2. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. Oh, and Tua going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked by Jared Wilson. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. 20. 10. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Part of what we just saw, that's a great example of a team that was really amped up. They've been playing so well, yet they didn't get overexcited and have a bust on defense and gave up a big play. Instead, they created their own big play with a pick six. This one may be over.
Yeah, it's just the first half, but that lead has swelled to the point where you're wondering if it is over already.
Josh Lambeau to kick off for Jacksonville.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
Javonte Parker, and that's a touchdown, but hold on. There is a flag down on the field. We'll have to see what this is about. Brutal, so take away the long touchdown.
It's a cruel game sometimes, partner.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. And the Jags get to him as down he goes. Adam Gotsis, the Aussie, with a sack.
3 scores down, not even a halftime yet. They are not getting much generated offensively. They've got to figure it out.
It's tough because this defense just seems to be playing with so much confidence right now.
They really are. They are on their toes, and they're getting at them.
He's airing it out for Williams. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception picked off by the rookie from Florida, C.J. Henderson. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. Well, you just kind of feel for him right now. 4 interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask there's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game. Go to the press conference, meet it head on, and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today, and you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity. A final shot before half for Kaepernick. That one complete. He finds Sharp. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 13 yards on the pickup, and it's going to yield a new set of downs.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line. Let's go, let's go.
They'll throw now on the final play. flush to his right. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. A lane opens here. He's past the 30. And they're going to wind up with pretty good starting field position as they get it up past the 35.
37-yard line.
The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
No gain on the play. It's now third and 8.
The Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Kaepernick's going to keep it. Oh, he tried to pitch it, and the ball's loose. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. He's thankful right now for that sideline because it could have been a fumble loss instead just a fumble, though they will have to punt it down.
You're right about that, but do you think there's ever been a player happier to see his own punter go on the field than him?
No.
I mean, not at all, right? How fortunate is he that they got a chance to punt it away, and it's not just a turnover at the spot.
At their own 34-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And Charles, they trail by 3 scores. Look, they're not completely out of this, but it's sort of go time right now.
Yeah, and they knew that coming out after halftime, it was going to take a collective effort to get back into this ball game. The defense got the stop for them, so maybe that can get things started. Now the offense has to put their game up as well. And if they can put a score on the board, hey, they could get back in it in a hurry.
Back to the air on second down, Tagovailoa. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete.
This is caught inside the 15. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Sometimes the one-handed catches are unnecessary, but he was trying to ward off the defender with the other. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Sidney Jones. And he'll go down inside the 15 at his own 13-yard line. And you have to wonder, Charles, in a game like this, 5 interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
But based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a 5th interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
The ball carried by number 3.
They give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
They go with Thompson again. And not a whole lot to speak of there as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a 3rd and about 4 for a 1st.
And the play brings up 3rd and 4.
And they'll try and run the option to pick it up. And this one into the hands of DJ Shark. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. Great job of tackling there to prevent the first down.
One of the toughest skills in football, open field tackling. A lot of times one-on-one against a shifty receiver. He got it done in a nice way that time.
Here comes Grant on the return. That'll go as a 42-yard punt, but a net of 32. They had a 10-yard return, and it'll be Dolphin football.
At their own 43-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at point.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by the rookie from Florida, C.J. Henderson. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted. But they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
31 yards there and a first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great...
Now the defense loses him. It's complete. Touchdown, Jaguars. DJ Chark with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the forced turnover on defense leads to 6 points.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
They're on 25-yard line.
Tagovailoa and the Dolphins come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. From the gun, he'll set up to throw. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Another attempt, another incompletion. And when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points. And the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
They throw again on second down. This one's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Preston Williams.
11 yards there. First down.
First down, Dolphins.
From the gun, it's Tua. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Josh Jones. The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
A throw out wide by Kaepernick is caught. A gain of 6 there on first. Was that a design pass or what was that?
It was built into the play call. He had the opportunity to either hand it inside, keep it himself to run it, or do what he just did. Throw that pass inside, hitting a receiver on the run.
Line of scrimmage, the 43 on 2nd and 4. They run with Thompson. And he'll get this down close to a first down at about the Dolphins' 36. Calling a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Minshew's going to try and run it. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
That It's the end of the third quarter.
Back now in Jacksonville. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four. And now a first chance for the backup here to throw to Thompson on the screen. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. 27 yards there, a first down.
Well, Barton, nothing but praise for me for this offense. They have been tremendous all night long. They knew what they had to do to unlock the defense. And let's face it, this has been a master class in offensive football that we've been here to witness.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10.
Hey, Mike 51.
I got you.
They run. Robinson. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5.
A gain of 4. Brings up 3rd and 5.
Out of the gun is Minshew. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on 3rd down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected 4th down here.
And Lambeau will put this one through, but now there is a penalty marker on the field, so let's see what this is about. They're down here in the 4th, and that personal foul penalty's not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
They'll try and run. This is Robinson. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2.
Ball carrier.
Good first step there defensively, but they're still knocking on the doorstep, so maybe another run here?
I think so. One of my favorite coaches used to say, son, if you could darn near lay down near the end zone and get in, give me my best power running play with my best back right now.
Again, it's Robinson, and he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line. Calling a gain of 1 yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's 3rd and goal.
1 yard on the play. It's now 3rd and goal.
Let's go one more.
Kaepernick now to throw. Got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. LaVisca Chenault with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Jaguars continue to roll. They seemingly just continue to score at will. And as great as it's been for the offense, you got to feel for that defense down there.
I love how you use the word will, because both teams came into the game with the will to win. But one team has obviously imposed its will on the other and broken them. Because what we're seeing right now, wow, that's a defense that's in tatters after what they faced in this ballgame. In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the 4th quarter. This would be their 3rd straight defeat. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled.
Wilson made the tackle.
1st down yardage on the first play of the drive. Give him 14.
1st down, Miami.
This is Breida. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30.
Ball carrier.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of three. And guess what? It brings up third down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. It'll be a gain of four, but it won't be enough. It leaves him with a fourth down now.
Fourth down.
Here's Matt Hawk now, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. Taken in at the 11. It's a 45-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10.
Big stop, G. Big stop. Let's go.
And they will take a knee here. Take a knee as the clock ticks down toward 50 seconds to go. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now, third and long.
51, Mike. Mike 51. I've got him.
And they'll indeed take a knee.
Charles